A warm welcome to all of you. We are in the midst of this second wave of COVID-19, and it is hitting us very badly. And so many questions arise. Where is God? Where is Jesus when all this is happening? And this evening, we have with us some youth who are working in the midst of this deadly second wave. We have with us some young healthcare professionals. And let's listen to them first. First, we have with us a youth from Nasik, Audet D'Souza. Audet had done her BSc in nursing, MBA in hospitals and healthcare industry. And currently, she is the center manager at Suburban Diagnostics, a place in demand these days, because that's the place where the COVID tests are done. Audet?
Yes, good evening, fathers. Good evening, everyone else.
Good evening, Audet.
Hope everyone is doing safe amongst the pandemic, which has impacted us a lot. So, thank you, Father, for the brief introduction. So, as you can see, that I'm at home, but with the mask. So, it clearly depicts that I have become COVID positive in spite of taking both the doses of vaccination. So self-awareness is one major factor which I feel is lacking amongst all of us. We have taken things lightly once things have opened up, but precaution, prayer, and understanding the fact that there is something called coronavirus that is affecting our lives is very important. My mom, my dad, both are affected with COVID-19. Mom is affected slightly at a higher rate than my dad and myself. But prayers and positive attitude towards life is getting us strong and getting us straight. It is hard. When I used to hear people saying that, I lost my smell sensation, I cannot taste. But when I myself experienced it, when I still do not have any taste, any smell. I cannot smell things. So it really feels weird. When a moment you can smell something, and the very next moment you don't know what smell is. So we have to take things seriously. And one thing that has kept me strong is faith in God. Faith that things will end very soon. Faith that there is a reason why things are happening in such a way. And it's God's plan. Nothing goes against His plan. So if it is His will and His power that will keep us going.
Okay, Audet, thank you for sharing with us. And definitely know that Audet had been very much involved in this COVID testing process, as she is the manager of that testing center. And in the bargain, she and her family also had to have undergo this suffering. Next, we have with us another youth. Her name is Jis Mary. She is a nurse from Holy Family Hospital. And coming from the front line, she is going to speak to us about her experiences during these days. Jis?
Good evening, everyone.
Yes, Jis, good evening.
Father. Shall I start, Father?
Yes, yes.
Good evening, everyone. So I will start the second wave with the Christ, which was the topic given actually what is going on. So I will start with a verse of from the Bible that is from Isaiah. Don't be afraid, I am with you. I am your God, let nothing terrify you. I will make you strong and help you. I will protect you and save you. That is from Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10. COVID-19 has forced many of us to review what we do and why we do it. It makes us feel vulnerable. But now I notice that people with strong faith can navigate the uncertainty better. So I myself, Jismeri Joseph, registered nurse working in Holy Family Hospital, Bandra. I'm here to share with you my experience of the second wave with the cries. When the reality stuck, I call upon God for strength and insight, and most of all, the ability to lead by His wisdom. This pandemic has made me think of the reason I became a nurse. I was passionate and eager to help people around me and to bear other people's burden, not knowing God was guiding me in the direction of my nursing vocation. COVID-19 is unprecedented and its impact has been overwhelming. One day, I came to work as usual and was informed that a unit has been converted to COVID-19 unit for the hospital. I was a little afraid, but at the same time, I was feeling proud that God has chosen me to serve His people. As the day passed, I gained rich experience. This is different, I felt, but I never imagined anything like what we are experiencing today. Even today, there are many unanswered questions about the virus. We have seen many patients lose their lives due to this deadly disease without their loved ones around them. But we also know many patients who recovered after contacting with the virus. We know hospitals are trying different treatment modalities to care for the patient. The fear continues and are real, especially working in a frontline. Two things minimize my fear. First, the knowing more about the disease and how to care for our patients. All about the convicts that I have God's protection of all of us keeps me going steadfastly. Most of my shifts are long and stressful, starting from dawning till doffing. The nurse has to feel the heat in a PPE kit, wearing an N95 mask for over 6 hours. Without meeting my basic needs,
has brought the youth together to make them aware.
But my strength is the Lord. I find my fulfill in taking care of the sick, watching them get better and returning to their homes. The number of patients recovering from the disease is a great hope for all the healthcare professionals. It's a sign that we are winning this battle with COVID-19. Although we are not there yet, we need to be watchful and alert as the situation seems alarming today. I feel deeply called to serve God through the healing ministry through my nursing profession. I also believe that nurses, as the healthcare providers with a caring spirit, extend their loving and self-sacrifice service to the humanity. I would never render my service so effectively if the Lord would not be my side, assuring His healing to sick and wounded. So I would like to conclude with Jeremiah chapter 13, verse 17. But I will restore you to health and heal your wounds, declares the Lord. Thank you.
Thank you, Jis. Thank you, Jis Mary, for sharing those rich experiences. And I'm sure both these short talks have put us in perspective of what you're going to have this evening as we are dealing with this second wave with Christ. I'll just put some questions to this group and feel free to share or answer these questions. First thing is, just as Audit and Jis have shared their experiences, anything do you have to share about COVID-19 and how it has affected you or somebody else, but still you feel that Jesus is still there holding the boat. Jesus is still there in the boat with you. Okay. Anybody can share. It's open. Unmute yourself before you speak, because all of you are muted. Okay, as you all are thinking about it, another question also I'll put forth. Okay, so that is more easier to answer, and then you can answer this question also connected to it. What can we do in this situation? This situation, the second wave that is affecting so many of us, so those who are close to us, what can we do as young people? What is it that we can do? Let me ask another young medical professional, Dr. Nivedita, would you like to share?
Good evening, fathers. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
About this, we all are in this difficult situation.
Somebody has to mute your video. Yes, Nivedita.
This coronavirus pandemic has shaken the world and also our faith in some way or the other. Sometimes we might feel that God is not with us. He has abandoned us. But that is not the situation. I myself was exposed to the virus ample number of times working in the health sector. But thankfully, by God's grace, I was symptom free. Nothing happened to me till date. Even if we feel that if God is not with us, but still as a people of faith, we should trust in the power of God and in the providence of our loving God. As a people of hope, we know that God will never abandon us. And then despite our own fears and anxiety, we should stand in solidarity with our brothers and sisters who are affected with this virus and try to help them with our prayers, at least with our prayers. If we cannot... of course, we're not allowed to see them or meet them, but with our prayers, we can contribute. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Anybody else would like to share on either the experience that you have and how you feel Jesus is there with us in this moment, or what we can do?
I'd like to share my experience.
Yes, Veronica.
Hi, good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
So this was like a week back, 2 weeks back in the Holy Week, where my granny was tested positive. She's like about 70 right now. So it wasn't an easy thing for us. Like, she took vaccine on Monday and then she tested positive on Tuesday, where oxygen levels started dropping and she was breathless, and it was around 10:30 night. And then we were searched for a nearby hospital, was a government one, because private hospitals are very far. So when we took at the vaccination center, it's a hospital, so they told us we don't have an ICU nor a oxygen cylinder, so I'll have to shift. And it was 1 a.m. So no other hospitals were allowing her, since she's 75 right now. So it was very difficult for us. So someone suggested we take her from Vilipale to Jogeshwari. So at night, 3 a.m., we shifted her from Vilipale to Jogeshwari. It was not an easy task. There also, we went, there was no ICU available, and she was in much need of oxygen. So doctors told me and my dad to sign a document saying ki if anything happens to her, we are responsible. And we had to sign it because we had no other option at 3 a.m. to shift her anywhere, and she was in much need of oxygen. So luckily she got a bed, a bed in the hospital. That was the only bed available for that day, because since it's a COVID center, so patients are coming going. So we were there till 5 a.m. and 6 a.m. the doctors told ki still her condition is the same, so we are not sure if she's going to live. So like, it was shocking for us, but I asked many other priests and nun friends to pray for her, and really the prayers worked. And then morning only I was allowed to visit her, but I was not sure if it's a COVID ward, so I went without a PP kit. I just went with a mask. So the doctor shouted at me, but then I knew ki I have to go for her. So I went anyhow. It was a COVID ward, and without a PPE kit or without gloves, I just entered there. And this, like, she was there for around 11 days. And on Holy Saturday, properly, we got a call ki, you know, she's doing fine. We can just take her. Because we were, like, very upset. We can't celebrate Easter. But we kept praying, and we had that faith ki God is going to work a miracle. And since Easter is coming, we are going to experience this miracle in our lives. And luckily, on Saturday, Holy Saturday, after we heard the online mass, we got a call from the hospital. You can just come to take your patient. First, they told she'll have to go under dialysis because her creatinine level, everything went high. So we are like, dialysis, she cannot do.
Was having something else on.
Sorry?
No. Somebody else was talking. You continue, Yeah.
So I know ki the power of prayer, how powerful it is. It is a powerful weapon to prosper during this time of trouble, during this evil thing we are going through. And luckily on Holy Saturday evening, she got discharged from the hospital. And I can say ki prayers have been the only thing which had kept me going through this all 11 days. So I will say ki this was like a experience for me to draw closer to God. Thank you.
Thanks, Veronica.
Okay, Father Leslie.
Yes, Leslie. Yeah.
Father, I would like to share my experience. Now, your very first question now, how the COVID has affected us.
You're a little now, soft. Can you hold the mic closer to your mouth? Yeah.
Okay, just give me a moment. Okay, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, Father, your very first question was like, how the COVID has affected us. Now I was working in Bombay, all right? So I lost my job, okay? So from past 1 year, I'm sitting over here at home and chilling out. So, but one thing that happened good was like, I came very close to the Lord, okay? I got an opportunity to attend all the sessions which you had held, okay? And I also got an opportunity to attend the masses at the shrine. For the very first time, I did it for the entire Lent. During the entire Lent season, I went to church, and Jesus Christ is surely there, okay, and he is also answering our prayers. But it is also our responsibility to take care, to maintain social distancing, wear the mask, make the people aware about all this. We should take care of ourselves. We should tell people how we should take by keeping social distancing, wearing masks, washing your hands. This thing really helps. Yes, Jesus Christ is surely there, and but then it is our responsibility as well to take care of ourselves and make the others also make, because at my road, most of them have passed away because of this COVID-19, okay, and because of they did not take care of themselves. We can say that. And some of them are also affected because I have seen them at the market, okay, roaming around, and today they are affected by the COVID-19 disease. So it is our responsibility to take care of ourselves. This is what I would like to share. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks, Leslie. Anybody else? Okay, one more thing. You can answer any of these questions. What has COVID-19 taught us? Okay, or is teaching us? Anybody would like to reflect on this? What has COVID taught us or is teaching us?
Yes, Father, I would like to answer this question.
Yes, you're very
What COVID has taught us? COVID has taught us many things. Like the person who's very close to you, very dear to you, if he's quarantined, or if you yourself got COVID and you want someone really near, No one is there. So how is our faith in God, the living one? Are we really clinging to him? At times we feel like, oh, I'm affected by this coronavirus. Various things come up in your mind. But when you're affected by that, do you really think that God is near? And if you come out of this COVID-19, do you really thank God for that? The breath what you take is, it's free of cost. You don't value. But when you go on the ventilator in an ICU for this COVID thing, and doctors say you don't have, we don't have oxygen. How precious is that breath for us? And this COVID situation has really taught us to thank each and every moment. You never know what is next moment. You're going, taking injections, this vaccination and all. But as likely Odette also said, she has taken 2 injections, but still she's affected. Maybe it's God's will that you have to come out of this situation. Many of us has gone through this pain to this difficult moment, but are we really thankful for that? And are we really the person who has gone through it? Are we really thankful for what has happened to us? Those who have lost their life, it's very sad for us to know that our loved one, we can't even see the death of our loved ones. The doctors don't even give you a body. What uncertain thing has come up? Really, you have to think on this. A thing where you cannot even see your loved ones coming to you, seeing you, then what kind of life are you living in? Weddings also can happen in 5 or 10 people. Sorry for the disturbance. What kind of life are you living in? In what kind of world are you living in? Where you can't have your own loved ones. You only have that Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, who can shelter you, who can protect you. So are we really thankful for that? And this COVID situation, even in 10, 5 people also you can live. But are you thankful for that little thing where you want huge crowd to come in for your wedding, for your birthdays, or maybe for anything, even for your funeral? But only with 2 or 3 people also life can go on. And what you have to give in this world, only love. When a patient is affected by this, he's only seeking for love. That hunger is there for love, and that someone should come and visit. But due to this deadly disease, no one is allowed to come near you. How you utilize that time when you're on that bed, when you are affected by this coronavirus, how you are utilizing that time? Maybe you can ask Odette or maybe anyone who has gone through this pain and has come out of this. They will be able to answer you very well. What exactly they feel like. Maybe I'm sitting here just talking, but I don't know what is happening in front person's mind. You always have to be thankful, and you cannot say, oh, he's affected by this coronavirus. Now, just few days back when I was supposed to go to office, there were 3 people who were affected and they were just sitting next to me, and I myself am marked safe. So am I thankful for that I'm marked safe? By the precious blood of Jesus, I'm healed. I'm not affected by anything. Are you really thankful for that? Life can go on. Work is going on. See, now when we are working from office, now they have given work from home. Are we really thankful for that? So you have to just thank and praise God. You have to keep trust in the living one. That's what I would like to say.
Thank you, Ulrich, for your deep reflections.
Thank you.
Anyone else?
Hi, Father. I'd like to say something.
Yes, Soshi.
Yeah, so COVID has taught me not to take things for granted at all. My dad got tested positive on the 2nd of April, and he passed away on the 7th of April, just last week. So it's very saddening, but it has taught me not to take even a single moment with your loved ones for granted. Like, spend as much as time as you can with them pray with them, talk to them, instead of getting being glued to your telephones or televisions or laptops. Spend time with them, because you do not know COVID or not COVID. You do not know when is the last moment you're going to spend with them. My dad did not have any COVID symptoms much. He was just normally taking his medicines that he had and all of those things. And then suddenly on the seventh morning, he had his breakfast. And then he just spoke to my sister for some time. And then he stopped responding. We lost his pulse. We tried everything. It was such a big shock, because he didn't say a word. He didn't say that he's breathless, or he didn't say that he's feeling like he didn't have any cough. He didn't have any cold, nothing. He just went away silently. But one thing it's a very big loss for us, but I'm thankful. I feel blessed that at the last moment that when my dada was going, he was with us. He wasn't in a hospital ward where we couldn't see him. We had his body with us. We had a good funeral. So all of my cousins, we couldn't attend, because along with my dada, we three of us, my sister, myself, and my mama, were tested positive. All praise to God, we are now negative. But that time we were positive, so we couldn't attend the funeral. But my brother came down from Rajasthan. I have an elder brother and a younger sister. So he came down, and with all of my cousins and uncles and all, we had a proper funeral. They say, I'm from Gujarat, by the way. So they say the situation in Vadodara, where I am right now, is very bad. They don't give coffins, or they don't give, like, we're not allowed to put the corona-infected bodies in a coffin, or they are not even giving a cross or nothing. It's just dumped. There's this bulldozer that comes and digs the mud, and they put the bodies in that. But I'm blessed, and my dada was lucky that we had a proper coffin, a proper cross, and there was a proper funeral. We organized a Zoom link, and our parish priest also told the final burial rites. When I see other, it's sad for me when I look that I don't have my dada anymore, but I'm happy that he had a proper funeral as compared to other people who they're going through. I'm happy that my dada had a good funeral. And each time I get emotional and I start to break down, I remember that Jeremiah 29:11, that God has better plans, and maybe he took away my dada so my dada can intercede for us from heaven. And yeah, sorry for breaking down. That's what I wanted to say. Thank you. Stay strong, stay safe. And I like to add, my dad was a person that took uttermost care with sanitizing everything. He took care of himself, he took care of us. He used to sanitize every single thing, every time he went out, every time he came back. But still he got corona positive. So sometimes, even though we take all the precaution and we take all steps to keep ourselves safe, we are not really safe, because the other person in front is not aware, is not taking care, is careless. I still see people joking around about corona, saying it's nothing serious, it's nothing nothing harmful. But then I feel like telling them, I lost my father because of it, and it's damn serious, so you better start taking all precautionary steps. So I'm sorry I'm taking up too much time, but all I'd like to say is, please take this seriously. It's not a joke. Please keep yourself safe and keep others safe also. Thank you.
Thank you, Oshin. Thanks for sharing your pain. And we truly keep you and your family in your prayers. Anyone else? Definitely. Many of us have gone through some kind of experience related to COVID, and some more painful, like what Oshin shared, some experiences which has been a huge pain for some youth, for some of us. Let's now express all this in the form of a song. So we have this Sasha, who is going to sing a song for us based on today's theme. So she will introduce what this song is about and she will sing that. So, Sasha?
Yes, Anu. A very good evening to everyone. Before I say anything, I just want to offer my condolences to Oshin. And I think she's really brave to share her experience in front of everyone. We all knew that COVID was going to prevail for very long, but I don't think that anybody imagined it to be this bad again. And in the second lockdown, most of us are feeling extremely lonely. So many of us and our friends and families are far away from home. They're in hospitals or stuck in some other state or city. So through this song, let's ask our all-powerful, almighty God, who has the power to do anything, to listen to our prayers, to be with us during this time of distress, and to lead us out of it very soon. Please listen to the lyrics intently, and Father Leon will also put the lyrics in the chat box. The first song is called With You By My Side. It's by David Haas. When I'm feeling all alone and I'm far away from home, God, I need you to hear me. When my friends all turn away, then I ache to hear you say, Lord, you are with me through it all. You are the light, you're the song that I'm singing. Whom should I fear when you are with me? For you are my God, and with you there is nothing I can't do. With you by my side, with you by my side. We find our hope in Jesus. We find our strength in Jesus. He is our solid ground, our comforter, our all in all. In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. No guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, you're in the power of Christ I stand. Till he returns or calls me home, you're in the power of Christ, I'll stand.
Thank you, Sasha.
Thank you, Father.
Father Glenn, would you like to share anything on these questions?
Can you hear me? Because, or am I too soft?
Yeah, it is soft.
Then maybe I'll move to the phone.
Okay.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes. Okay. Yes, Father Glenn.
So first of all, it's a very deep sharing, very personal.
Father, you're still very soft.
Is it? I'll leave the other meeting.
Father Glenn?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, now you're clear.
Okay. So first of all, thanks a lot for the very deep sharing and reflections, everything that young people are going through. And for us here in Provincial House also, we have an experience of 4 of our Salesians at the moment with COVID. And 9 of them actually went for the test, and we were hoping that we would not get the 5th one, because if the 5th one had to be identified as positive, then our entire provincial house would have been locked down. But I can imagine everything that you all are going through. We too are going through here in provincial house. We have got fathers of all different ages, and the anxiety is there. The anxiety is there, definitely. It has disturbed our regular schedule, our workplace, everything has been shut. And so it is in this moment we actually realize how fragile our lives are. It just takes one breath. That's all it takes to get the virus. And yet in the midst of all this, we experience so much of love, so much of care, so much of protection, and we believe in the power of prayer, and that's what is taking us through at this moment. Everyone here in Provincial House is all focused. We are taking the utmost care to break the chain so that it doesn't spread, but we are all in God's hands. We are all fragile, and this COVID, the second wave, it's a deep sea in which we are all in, and only with Jesus in the boat will we be able to tide over the second wave. So it challenges our faith, it challenges our real love for one another, our solidarity. Every day we get messages, we get phone calls. So many of our Salesians across Salesian India are with COVID. So many of the Salesian parents, brothers, sisters, in-laws, many of them also have passed away. And so this is a time when we mourn, when we share our losses, when we are at the end of the day, we come to the feet of the Lord, believing that God's protective and healing hand will come upon us and protect us. And this is our faith. Yeah, that's what I'd like to share.
Thank you, Father Glenn.
Yeah.
Oshin? Are you Oshin? Can you please
yes, Father.
Say a prayer?
Yes, Father.
Before we conclude this session.
Lord Jesus, thank you for this day. Thank you for keeping us safe all throughout the day. We pray for the safety and good health of all those who have joined this meeting and those who couldn't for whatever reason. Looking at the current situation, it's really, really hard to come to you in prayer. There is sadness, chaos, and distress all over. Sickness and death has spread all over. People have lost their loved ones. Console their grieving hearts, Lord Jesus. Be a source of strength and courage for them. At this hour, when this pandemic is at its extreme, touch our hearts, Lord. Make us more empathetic to one another. Help us spread your love and care. We pray for our government officials and health authorities that they are guided on the right path and take steps for the eradication of the virus. We pray that people may sensitize themselves to the current situation and decrease the curve of coronavirus. We also pray that the vaccine may help preventing the spread of the virus, that it may be available to everyone in this society. We pray for the speedy recovery of all infected people. Lord Jesus, we pray that you wash us all with your precious blood and protect us. You promised us in Psalms 91 that no harm would come to us, that no calamity or disaster can ruin us. Protect us all, O Lord, and help us to come to you in prayer all the days of our life. Amen.
Father Glenn, can you give us the final blessing?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
As Ocean rightly prayed, Psalm 91, you shall not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that roams in darkness, nor the plague that ravages at noon. We come before you, Lord, and in a special way through the powerful intercession of our Blessed Mother, Our Lady of Lourdes, the Mother of Good Health. I pray that the Lord continue to bless, protect your families, bless each one of you, and may the peace and the healing power of the Lord Jesus be with you, especially during the second wave. I make this prayer and bless you in the name of Jesus, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you, Father Glenn. Thanks to all of you who contributed, who shared your thoughts, your experiences, for the song by Sasha, to Audet, Jis, Oshin, Yuldrich, and others, Leslie, all who shared. Thanks for making this evening an enriching one, and I'm sure that we know that Jesus is there with us in our boat. Some boats have been rocked vigorously, but still Jesus is there with us. With that trust and faith, let's move ahead with that faith. Thank you very much. Yeah, thanks for joining.